me volunteering for Congressman Dent. As many of you know, I used to be a Republican. I've been very forthright about that. When I looked into it, has come up with the same conclusions. We are going to have to raise government revenue, and we are going to have to modify some popular government programs. This is what the Simpson-Bowles Commission concluded. Only people that don't realize this are the congressional leaders in Washington. You have congressional Republicans that believe you can balance the budget just by cutting Planned Parenthood or foreign aid, and that you don't need to raise taxes even on the wealthiest people in society. And to be fair, there are some congressional Democrats who believe that you could just put a surtax on billionaires and you don't need to make reforms to Social Security and Medicare so that they're around for my generation.
Every single bipartisan group that's looked at it has come to the same conclusion. The Simpson-Bowles Commission, the DiMonici-Rivlin Commission, the Gang of Six, all of whom have come up with the same recommendations. As hard as it may be to hear, we are going to need to raise government revenue, and we are going to need to modify some popular government programs. The only people that don't seem to get this are congressional leaders, Republicans, and to be fair, many congressional Democrats. On the one hand, you've got Republicans in Congress who believe that you can balance the budget simply by cutting symbolic programs like NPR or Planned Parenthood, and that you don't need to raise taxes even on the top 1% of society. And for their part, there are some congressional Democrats that believe that you could just put a surtax on billionaires and that you don't need to make modifications so that Social Security and Medicare are there for the rest of us. We're going to need to raise government revenue, and we're going to need to modify some popular government programs.
When I hear Jackson say modify popular programs, I fear that that's code language for going after Medicare and Social Security. I don't support it. In terms of deficit reduction, with what we pay into Medicare and with what we take out, there's a gap. Even with that gap, as Americans, we should pay for Medicare as it is today and not cut any of those programs or any of those services for senior citizens.